I want to get right back into this. That one I just won. Damn. Sorry, I was trying to get to the point where I was at. I think I was at his jaws bouncing place. One! Clay yelled, waving his arms and trying to usher them together towards the door. Clay, why is it with me? Charlie was rooted to the ground, unable to take her eyes off of the beast. Wait! Jackson cried suddenly. Clay, these arms, just like the others, they're not the last children. What? He said. In other days, stopping his fancy mirror and looking fully confused.
Choose it!
Clever girl! Oh, sorry. Had to. Jester screamed. Clay clenched his jaw. Then raised the gun and aimed at Freddy's gaping mouth. He fired once. The shot only beat from Charlie, and it was deafening. Freddy jerked back. The frightful knife. And for a split second, his ears blurred and distorted. The unnaturally left mouth began to close. But before it could, Clay fired again. Three more times in quick succession. With each shot, the creature seemed to grit. It blurred. Watching around the edges, Freddy's mouth was killed in on itself. Not quite closing, but shrinking inward. First the bat hunched forward around its mouth. Clay fired one last. For Freddy's head, one with the animatronic toggle forward and mistaken him on the ground. Freddy's image flickered like a dragon on a terrorist screen. The color faded from his fur. Then everything that needed Freddy winked out. Mean hopefully passive bigger in his place. It looked like the rest of the unchunked in the room. A bright American Swiss of old scout witness. Charlie opposed the thing that had been Freddy cautiously. The winging in his ears were beginning to fade. He crouched down next to the creature, tilting her head to start. Not like the other racks of Freddy's, she said. These things don't marry the fur badly. They're made of us. By twisting our mind. The words came out of the white loosest. She had no expression to it. Charlie started softly. He stepped forward, but she ignored him. She touched the creature's smooth skin. It felt like something between plastic and human skin. A strange, malleable substance that was a little too soft. A little lick. The feeling of it made her nauseous. Charlie leaned over the body, ignoring her disgust, and plunged her fingers into one of the bullet holes. She dove around in a swiftly organic stuff on the chest cavity, attending not to her gesture and play process. Then she found it. Her fingers touched the disc, which was bent in half, almost broken. Charlie pried out a second piece of metal that was wedged inside. He stood up and held it out to the others. A bullet whistled apart. "You shot the chip," he said. "You killed the illusion." No one spoke. Ted cried. Charlie was suddenly aware of the racket they had just made, and had been so accustomed to the ailment. The silence was broken by a clicking sound. The noise, of course, on a tire. They all whirled to see, from what had appeared to be a dark and empty corridor, a white figure the way for the shadow and stalked towards the upright but hunched forth as if uncertain and whether to walk a beast or a they backed his way for Charlie Sook about it punch as he clasped butter. He shouted, "Look out!" Stop, turning to see his eye widened as a tantrum. "There!" he cried. A fire shot into the dark. They turned. An 8-foot sleeping body. The rabbit found the creature on the floor was blocking the doorway behind. Its head was towards the body, its eyes glowing white hot in the dark. Its mouth was open, revealing several green teeth. Clay fired again, but the bullet had no effect. "How many bullets do you have left?" John said. "Clay fired three knots." Started by it, then no disgust. "We," said John. "I had we." "Wow, this guy's an idiot. You just wasted all your money you shot on someone behind you. What is this? Well, do what you must." On the corner of the eye, drawn a hole. So John and Tricks have drawn closer together. Still behind Clay. She stayed where she was as the others retreated. Satisfied by the two advancing figures, the wolf and the rabbit, both tall. "Charlie," John said with a warning tone. "What are you doing? Come back." "Why did you bring me here?" Charlie asked. One of the creatures all. Her chest was tight. Her eyes ached. But she's been holding back tears as well. "What do you want from me?" she shouted. Look. "What is this place? What do you know about my brother?" She screamed, a full roar. She flung herself in the wall. She tore giant chunks of beef as if she could tear her father out there. by the way. Human hand zipped up and pulled it back. Not time to yet. Charles, we need to go. Now. She pulled it up. Back. But remained where she was. Her breath was unsteady. She wanted to scream. Until her lungs gave out. She wanted to close her eyes. She perished. Emerge from darkness. Instead, she looked again for body to the nameless wall. And asked, oh, so calm, children to pass. What do you want for me? They don't care about you. I am the one. I'm the one that brought you here. A voice from the darkness. In the same shallow corner the wolf had emerged from. The wolf went and the wolf straight in the posture as it was darting into the room. He's gonna know that voice, Jessica whispered. A figure began to limp forward, obscured by the darkness. No one moved. Charlie realized he was holding her breath. But she didn't hear any other mouse eating sign either. But the unable suffer that was coming. But I was the size of a man. His body was contorted, dropping to one side as it lunged towards school. You have something that belongs to me, said the voice, and the figure stepped into the light. Charlie grasped and heard John shot into the grass. Impossible, Charlie whispered. She felt John move up to stand behind her, but she didn't take dare. She didn't dare take her eyes off the man who stood before. His face was dark, his colored, grotesque, and swollen and wet. Cheeks that had been hollow were now distained with the float of decay. His eyes were bloodshot, the burst of death. His threading through the eyeballs that just a little too transcendent. Something inside them had gone bad. Jerry-like. At the base of his neck, Charlie could see two pieces of metal gleam. They extended from within his neck. Charlie lumped Daniel from his mouth to his skin. He wore what had been a mask of a young person. What? Now green remote. Dave? Desperately. Don't call me that. No. I haven't been Dave for a long time. He welled out one of his new hands, but so on the other side of the body. Where are you now, Tom? Then, of weapons,
on again, he hissed. I accepted that the new life that you gave me, you made me one for my creation. My name is Springtrap.
The man who had once been dead. Crying the name of the horse, we dance once to scroll the face back into a grin.
I'm more than Arthur was. I'm far more than hell.
Well, you spell terrible, Jessica clicked. I like this skill.
me free to my destiny. I've been a master of all these creatures. He quoted his bit, coming a sharp gesture towards Bonnie and all. Took two steps in, or see all the amateurs are linked together. What a system designed to control the chords of the shell. Now I control that system. I control the choreography. All this one. To me, I'll shut up this. Winter shuffled forward, and Charlie shrank back. I owe you both another debt of gratitude. I was imprisoned in that tomb. Beneath the stage, can't be able to move, only to see through the eyes of my creature. Just to let the two behind, but all that I could see, I was trapped. Eventually, they would have pulled me out, but having you do just that was a delightful surprise. He met Charlie's eyes. The muscle twins in his cheek. Get away from me. Don't come any closer. As if we are forced, he shifted nearer to her. She would have felt his breath on her face if he still breathed. Winter was the bent hand. The thick, grip suit was ragged. Bringing a human skin through the gap. She could still see the creases of the metal. Pins and wads had themselves alongside bone and candles into a rusted shadow gallop. He touched the back of his hand to Charlie's face. Smoking her cheek was a blubber child. From the corner of her eye, she saw Joel and start forward.
No, it's okay,
forced herself to say. I won't hurt your friend, but I need something from you.
You have to be kidding,
she said. Whistle. Mouth twisted into something that grotesquely resembled a smile. John had a fine great grin.
Then just in time to see Clay loading one bullet quietly into his gun. Clay shook. You never know when a corpse may run out of the shadows wearing a rabbit suit. He slays on, steady himself, and fired.
Breaker recoil.
Kids!
Clay shouted.
The door!
Charlie jerked her eyes away from Breaker. Almost painfully, as if then exercised some hypnotic force on her. Bonnie leave me clear. Craig, John, and Jessica began to warn Charlie. Grasp back, reluctant to go. Then join the others. They went back where they came from. I lean the egg. Stay well through the combo game.
The looning features the mascot.
He strode past me ahead, as if he knew the way. Charlie would never have questioned that. No, how did you find me? They were chased by sound, scrapping metal and the crank of the wolf's claws. In the open space, the noises echoed strangely, seeming to come from every side. If our army pursued them, Joey quickened her step. She scrammed up at John, seeking reassurance, but his eyes were on Gray ahead of them.
They reached the room with the waterfall. Again, Gray knew the footpath.
He had directed to the passage beneath the cliff, the where the water and theirs.
They pressed through it one by one.
John, with a 2-foot-old walker, went out bending over, and Charlie felt a quick pain recovery. Oh, so thick. Halfway through the passage, Gray paused, standing most of the awkward distance. Gray the neck, dunning something onto me.
Gray!
Charlie hissed. I have an idea, he said. 2 shadows emerged from the far side of the room. Jesse glanced back and glanced at the blacklit tunnel. Sized her to one for it. But Gray shook his head. Instead, he guided the group backwards. None of them taking their eyes to the monsters, or the seal the mouth of the river. That besieged the world. The armored chunks were approaching the water, hesitant. Both sniffed at it and shook his head. A body sprang up down and said, don't worry. Place it there.
Can't cut that thing, right?
Charlie said. Scissors starting to her. 2 masters stepped unsteadily into her. Just again. And Charlie took up. 2 steps back. Slowly and deliberately, Charlie continued towards them to the waist-high water. The stepped on the blue bunny and fell. It don't completely under the water for now. Trash his body. Would do well, but against the wooden light, the step beaters take 2 more.
That's not possible, Charlie said.
I was looking at brilliant laughter as he whirled around. He was point trapped, his eyes clearly visible, peering through the back woods. But,
was that your plan?
He said.
Bring my robot, but it's only designed as your father.
Well then, I saw you made them fireproof as well.
Gray called down, his voice reverberated to the canvas and to the wow, puzzle. Then look at the water in the sea. It's glistening a little bit. Calling dancing on the sun. Right.
Gasoline!
Joey turned to face. Can't mind the walls. Stop. Breeze. Oh, we're empty. Right, I flung it onto the water. The top of the river caught fire.
Yeah, that's one way to set a river on fire.
There ain't no way you can creep river to the desert with that!
A flame blowing out. the tidehoy, a slowing the animatronics in the middle. The creatures struggle to the sound of the river. The guttural high priest screech. They manage to call the bat players to it. The illusion, the actor, the bat. Skin exposed. The fire are falling on the body. Two burning pearls on the floor. Charlie and the others watch as the story could just smell. Burning and agonized screams. They all stood frozen, mesmerized at the cushion. So, and what behind her? Charlie has a crying scream. Two of the monsters spring trap. Vanished in the mouth of the Nile, a backward cat. She took off after them, slumping into the air with eyes.
Charlie!
Cried Paul. He began to chase her, but the famous creatures had called across the floor. That China was the master, after the nine of destinies, and now brought the mouth of the cave with a blazing remain. Joyce set her eyes on the path ahead. She couldn't afford to walk back. The passage was narrow, still damp and ancient. The floor felt like the rock beneath her bare feet. But though it was uneven, it wasn't painful. The surface was worn and smooth. As soon as the dark of the cave closed over, out the spark from her tune. The tug of something so like her that it was her. Blood going to blood.
Sammy, she whispered.
His name glanced off the cave walls. They heard the sound of it. He had to decide. It her voice joined her to the floor on this up place.
It has to be you.
Charlie went faster, following a call that came. Sigh. She could hear distant echo of spring trap laughter at indoor, but she couldn't stop. Oh, him. Heather. A crazy, she thought she got glimpse of it. But he was always gone before her eyes had time to in the thought to go back right. The gate twisted and turned until she had no idea which direction she was headed. But she went on. Charlie blinked as something moved at the corner of her eye, just out of sight. She shook her head and ran on, but then it happened again. An unnatural thing. Neil White. There's out the wall, and we get the black stuff. I'm gonna end it here for now. See you guys next.